for being here. For the public speakers, we really appreciate it. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Karel Kilimnik, retired early childhood teacher. I'm speaking on behalf of Karel for the record. When I retired, I was teaching kindergarten and horrified what I was expected to do. Instead of a play-oriented, hands-on discovery approach, my students were brutally forced into relentless assessments in four cities for too long. So I was supposed to follow a highly restricted curriculum. My blocks and easels were banished, as was project time, where children could choose what they wanted to do and play with others as they explored a rich environment. Please note that the Common Core ECE standards were not developed by any educators. Young children learn by playing. I have included links to articles and research documenting this fact. I hope that you can take time to read them as you develop early childhood standards for our students. Defending the Early Years is a national organization focused on developmentally appropriate early childhood practice. Your articles document why standards and standardized testing are inappropriate for young children. Fred Rogers stated that play is the work of children. In the short and long-term, play benefits cognitive, social, emotional, and physical development. Children learn as they discuss problems, negotiate, analyze, make mistakes, experiment, collaborate, and cooperate with each other. Play provides an opportunity for teachers to observe critical thinking skills of their students. Play leads to creativity, capacity for problem solving, and love of learning. How does a child approach and solve problems? Children use many mathematical and scientific concepts as they negotiate their way. Building blocks provide multiple opportunities to foster beginning mathematical skills as children experiment with construction. It is up to teachers and administrators to provide them with a rich environment filled with many opportunities to explore. A literacy-rich environment filled with books, magazines, posters, signs, and recipes creates a desire to learn how to interpret and read. In my class, we always had an assortment of insects, hosted an annual embryology project, went on field trips to the local post office, to the art museum, discussed and wrote how everything we did worked. Young children need hands-on experience. This is how they learn. Look at kindergarten in Finland, where play guides everything. You have an article in front of you from The Atlantic about kindergarten in Finland, which Karel sent in previously. Outside play, inside areas such as housekeeping, ice cream store, hospital, all provide opportunities for children to learn and develop skills as that they will use as they progress through life. I just want to reiterate what Ms. Blunt said. Human students need human teachers. It's a very dangerous trend now. And you know, we as observers at the SRC just saw, just at the last meeting, $10 million more for online learning. That's in addition to the $10 million that was allotted about a year ago. And as we pointed out at that time, there is no research that shows that this is beneficial for children. Human children need human teachers. And as one of the previous speakers pointed out, you know, Mr. Hardy, you know, our kids come with issues. They're not just in school to learn, you know, reading, writing, arithmetic, and cursive with you on that one, but they're really there to learn how to interact with people. Computers will not do that for children. Human teachers, you know, deans, principals, that's what it's going to take. So we want to be on record of saying this blended learning, online learning is not beneficial for any children, but I think especially for our children here in Philadelphia. Thank you again for allowing me to read Ms. Kilimnik's statement.
Thank you.